Hello and welcome back to Sam's Disney Diary, episode number 110. To infinity and beyond, a look at what's next for Disney Parks and Resorts. Shortly after the opening of Walt Disney World's Toy Story Land, Disney Parks presented To Infinity and Beyond, a look at what's next for Disney Parks and Resorts. The presentation took place over at the Walt Disney World Coronado Springs Resort, which is currently in the middle of a major renovation itself, a 15-story expansion that looks absolutely amazing. Can't wait for that thing to open. Learn about Lightning McQueen's Racing Academy, what's new from Mickey and Minnie's Runaway Railroad, and what's new all over Disney Parks and Resorts worldwide. Hear directly from George Kalogridjs, the president of Walt Disney World Resorts, and Kathleen Powell, president of the Western region of Disney Parks, along with some other special presentations. Hope you enjoy. Thanks for watching Sam's Disney Diary. We'll see you next time. Kongaloosh!
Dedication ceremony this morning, right? Oh my goodness, and what a fun way to play big! It is a fantastic way to kick off the incredible summer happening right now at Walt Disney World. It's the perfect time to visit with new shows, attractions, and experiences that make this summer, well, incredible. More about that later. But before we see what else is going on at Walt Disney World, I'm told we have a special news report from our roving reporter. Take a look.
I'm Mark Daniel reporting from the heart of the Moara Valley in Pandora. And as the Navi say, Kante, that is below. Wow, I cannot believe I am actually here in Pandora. Oh, and if that isn't cool enough, I'm joined by a PCI representative right now.
Kante, Mark. My name is Danny Byron, and I'm a collector here with the Pandora Conservation Initiative. At the PCI, it is our job to explore and understand everything we can about Pandora's unique environment.
Perimeter breach!
Oh, I'm so sorry. I mean, I can't help myself. This is amazing!
It magnifies my strength and my mobility, but most importantly, it protects me from any potential environmental threats.
Wait. We're safe here, right? This is a safe area. I mean, this is a tourist destination.
Well, yes, Mark, it is safe to a point, but there are potential threats you have to worry about. Let's see, there's sting bats, dire horses, certain beasts if you get them riled up, viper wolves, hammerhead titanotheres, titanophores, there's banshees, pearl lemurs, oh, and of course the great Leonoptrix, which the Na'vi call Taruk, which means last shadow, because they believe that when you see its shadow, that's the last thing you're ever going to see.
You know what, I think I feel a lot better in a suit like yours.
Well, Mark, I think you're fine, but I'm getting ready to head out on patrol. Do you want to come with me?
It sounds like a good idea, but I think my lunch is almost ready at Satuli Canteen.
That's too bad, Mark. Maybe next time.
All right, well, thank you very much. Hey, if you want to see the utility suit in action, just take a quick 4.37 light-year trip to Pandora and check it out for yourself. I'm Mark, reporting for Pandora. See my co! And back to you. Wow, this is amazing. Oh, so I can high-five.
Wait a minute, Rich!
Oh, okay. I'm going to just stay back, and I'll follow you and try to remain safe.
Hey,
Well, before we bring out our first guest, I wanted to let you know that at the end of today's presentation, we're going to be hosting a Q&A with our Walt Disney Imagineering representatives to answer your questions. So, throughout the show, if you think of any questions you'd like to ask, text it along with your name and outlet to this number, 407-449-8825, and we may just answer it later. Now, our first guest needs no introduction. Please help me welcome the president of Walt Disney World Resort, George Kalogridjs. Hi, George. Welcome.
Thank you. Nice to see you. Great to be here.
Such a big day. It is not every day that you open a new land at Walt Disney World.
Yeah, it's actually wonderful. For over 25 years, families have shared the joy of experiencing Toy Story films together. Now we invite them into Andy's backyard to play big and to continue to make even more memories together.
Oh, these are exciting days without a doubt.
Yes, they are. If you think about it, we opened Pandora, the World of Avatar last year. We just dedicated Toy Story Land. And we will open Star Wars Galaxy's Edge in the late fall of 2019 as part of our total transformation of Disney's Hollywood Studios. That's three new lands in 3 years. We now call that the Disney theme park trifecta. It's been the most significant period of growth at Disney in the last 20 years.
Wow, well with all of those new lands, everyone's gonna wanna come to Walt Disney World.
That's very true, and we're getting ready. As you saw when you arrived here today, Disney's Coronado Springs is undergoing a massive expansion. The same is true at Disney's Caribbean Beach Resort. And also coming is the proposed Disney Riviera Resort, the 15th Disney Vacation Club property. And then there is our upcoming Star Wars themed hotel, which will transport our guests to a galaxy far, far away when it opens.
Wow, well it must take a lot of people to help make all that magic.
Oh yes. Of course, the real secret to the success of the resorts, the parks, and everything in between are our cast members. They have a knack for making our guests feel as if the entire destination was created just for them and their family. Our cast are truly the heart and soul of Walt Disney World.
That is so true. Now, George, I've been wanting to ask since I've arrived, what are those polka dotted vehicles that are parked outside the lobby?
Those are the minivans. Aren't they great?
I want one.
Our guests love them too, and it's easy, convenient, and a safe way to get around property for a very reasonable fee.
Well, so how do I call one? Do I just go out on the sidewalk and flag one down?
Actually, it's even easier than that. You go to request one ride from anywhere on property using the Lyft app on your mobile device.
Oh, well, that is easy. Now, George, I have another important question to ask.
Okay, go right ahead.
Wine Bar George. Is that named after you?
Well, I wish I could say that it was. But Wine Bar George at Disney Springs is named after George Meliotis, who opened California Grill at Disney's Contemporary Resort in 1995. That George is a master sommelier.
But there's not many of those around.
True. Only a little more than 240 in the entire world. In fact, Wine Bar George is the only wine bar in Florida that's actually owned by a master sommelier.
Oh, you seem very proud of that fact.
I am. In fact, Disney Springs is a great place and an excellent experience for our guests.
Oh, it really is. It's so much has changed since it's first opened, but there's still more coming, right?
Indeed. Disney Springs is known for world-class restaurants and for retail and for great entertainment. And we have a new NBA experience coming next summer.
Oh, well, that's perfect. Eat some dinner, play some basketball, hop in a minivan, and head back to a Disney resort. Sounds like a great time to me. Well, there's a lot of great experiences coming to Walt Disney World, George. Do you have any insight on what's happening at the other Disney parks?
Well, I could try to answer that, but I saw someone backstage who would be able to give us a greater perspective on the western region of our business. How does that sound?
Well, that sounds great. Who is it?
It's our new president of Disney Parks Western Region, Catherine Powell. She has leadership responsibilities for Disney resorts in Paris, Anaheim, and Orlando. And this is her first official appearance in her new role.
Well, I can't wait to meet her. Would you do the honors?
Absolutely. Ladies and gentlemen, please join me in welcoming Catherine Powell.
Thank you.
Congratulations on your new role.
Thank you.
My goodness, I think I speak for everyone here when I say we would love to hear your Disney story.
So how long have we got? A couple of minutes.
Let's do this.
So I joined Walt Disney Company in 2004, and actually I was based in London in the international division for 10 years, running what we called media distribution. So that was selling our programs, our channels, our digital products to all our clients in Europe, Middle East, and Africa. And then after 10 years in 2014, being British, I kind of want to say I was shipped to Australia, but actually I very willingly went to Sydney with my husband and three teenage boys. Was not a difficult decision for the family, and ran Walt Disney Company Australia and New Zealand. That basically meant running all the lines of business, consumer products, retail, stage shows, film distribution in Australia. So that was amazing. And then in 2016, moved to Paris to run Disneyland Paris, up the family again, but into the most magical job. And honestly, there, having spent 10 years working in the digital and the media space, suddenly to be where you see the brand physically, where you see where the brand touches the guest, and you see the difference, is unbelievable. And then recently had the opportunity for this new job, and I'll be relocating to Los Angeles in 2 weeks, so I really have gone around the world.
My goodness, it just hopped you around here.
I know.
Catherine, so George just walked us through some new experiences at Walt Disney World, and I know that other Disney destinations are experiencing similar growth. So Disneyland Paris.
Yes, it's been an incredible period for Disneyland Paris. Shortly after I joined, Disneyland celebrated their 25th. You see that beautiful shot of the castle, and actually just in front of the hub, John Legend was playing Beauty and the Beast live, which was the most amazing moment. It was absolutely incredible. So the park was looking beautiful. Then a few months later, and some of you may know this, Disneyland Paris was taken over wholly owned by the Walt Disney Company. So being a fully owned park now, it meant that basically we could have this incredible investment, which Bob Iger made with President Macron in February. And it is the biggest investment in Disneyland Paris since the launch of the park. So it's going to completely revitalize the Walt Disney Studios and change it. I mean, it's going to double in size. I think we have an image there. That's the artist impression, and you'll see it'll be anchored by lake, and then three themed areas with Marvel, Star Wars, and Frozen. And anybody who's been to the Walt Disney Studios in Disneyland Paris, that is an incredible transformation. So it's a renaissance for Disneyland Paris. It's wonderful.
Oh my goodness, it's so exciting! Well, I heard that you recently visited Disney's California Adventure in Anaheim for the opening of Pixar Pier. How is that?
Pixar, it's, do you know, I learned that there are 90 Pixar experiences across all our parks internationally, which is incredible. And this year, I mean, obviously we had Toy Story Land opening in Shanghai earlier in the year, the wonderful dedication moment this morning, which was so special. Toy Story Land is just
beautiful. Oh my goodness, how about Tim Allen walking on stage,
And I think he was really moved to see it. It's such a colorful and humorous and nostalgic. It's amazing. And you're right, last week Disneyland launched Pixar Pier. And they'd had Pixar Fest running over the spring, and the picture that we saw earlier was the nighttime show, which was absolutely beautiful, the picture of Up. And then we had Pixar Pier launching the Incredicoaster, which was a wonderful make, and I think that was literally me going sideways. It's really quite fast, the Incredicoaster, it's amazing. But they had the characters, they had amazing food locations that were inspired. You can see it there, Angers, hot dogs, you had Num Nums, cookies, there's entertainment. It was wonderful. And you can see with Pixar, you also see actually bottom right, the beautiful Incredibles float in, I think, the most beautiful parade.
Oh, well, I must have missed it.
Absolutely amazing. But you can see, as we saw, and we'll see with Toy Story Land and Pixar Pier, our guests have so much love and affection for Pixar and their characters, so it's a wonderful moment.
I understand. I do have a love for Pixar. What an exciting time for Disney parks all over the world. Oh, thank you both so much for spending your time with us.
Thank you.
Thank you, it's been a pleasure. Thanks.
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen, Catherine Powell and George Kalogridjs. Roving reporter is back at it again with another newsworthy report from Walt Disney World. Let's take a look.
Well, Mark, the Skyliner will transport guests through the earth to our amazing theme parks, Epcot and Hollywood Studios, as well as a few of our select Disney resorts, like Caribbean Beach Resort, Pop Century Resort, the Art of Animation Resort, and the new Riviera Resort, the proposed 15th DVC property.
Oh, that's a great idea. I mean, allowing guests to soar with the birds. So tell me, where did you guys come up with this wonderful idea?
Well, you know, as Imagineers, we're always dreaming and designing cool new experiences for all of our guests. I mean, just take a look at that view.
I know, I see it. It's so inspiring. I mean, I could stay up here all day, Dean. I mean, it's beautiful.
Oh, this will give guests a bird's eye view of the resort.
You know, and I can't wait to experience it when it's all up and running.
We're very excited for the opening as well.
Now, while we wait, you know what? Can we stay up here forever?
Of course. Well, at least until the lift operator returns from lunch.
Okay, well, that's going to give us more time to enjoy the view, Dean. Well, I'm Mark Daniel reporting from the sky. Back to you. Oh, this is nice. Oh, hey, Dean, is that the development for Star Wars Galaxy's Edge over there?
Oh, I'm not at liberty to say.
Oh, come on, the cameras are off, the mics are off. Give me some secrets, Dean.
This is not the site you were looking for.
That is not the site we're looking for. Move along. Move along.
Well, soon, guests will really be able to soar to new heights. Not to mention soar to a galaxy far, far away or drive through an animated world. So now let's hear about what the future holds at Disney's Hollywood Studios. But before I bring out our next guest, remember that you can text your questions for our Walt Disney Imagineering representatives with your name and outlet to 407-449-8825 for a Q&A session later today. Now, it is my pleasure to introduce the creative minds behind Star Wars Galaxy's Edge and Mickey and Minnie's Runaway Railway. Please welcome Executive Creative Director Scott Mallwitz, Executive Creative Director Kevin Rafferty, Producer Charita Carter, and Atlantic Walt Disney Imagineering Regional Executive Kathy Mangum. Working on the transformation of Disney's Hollywood Studios.
Awesome!
By the way, congratulations on the opening of Toy Story Land! So, beyond Toy Story Land, what other changes are on the horizons for Disney's Hollywood Studios?
Well, Toy Story Land is really just the beginning. We have started a multi-year transformation of this park, and we're just so excited about it. As you know, and as you saw today, you can go into Andy's backyard for Toy Story Land, but we're going to take you even further. You'll be able to walk into a charming cartoon at Mickey and Minnie's Runaway Railway. You'll be able to dance with your favorite characters at Disney Junior. Yeah, and as we all know, Scott, coming soon, you'll be able to go to a galaxy far, far away at Star Wars Galaxy's Edge.
Oh, well, with what we've experienced with Toy Story Land, I think we're all pretty excited for what's coming next. And with the addition of this land, Disney's Hollywood Studios is top of mind with guests for exciting and immersive attractions.
Oh, yeah, it still has some of our favorite Walt Disney World attractions. You can go on Rock and Roller Coaster, as we all know, Twilight Zone Tower of Terror, some of my favorites, Indiana Jones, Fantasmic every night. It is still home to so much exciting, we're just making it better.
Absolutely. And, you know, I was thinking, as we were talking about, this is going to be a very family-oriented experience, and you told me that there was going to be an announcement that's going to make everyone say, gotcha.
Yeah, not only do we open a park today, or a land today, but we have another announcement, and it's going to be starring somebody I've known very well for many years, Lightning McQueen. It will be at Disney's Hollywood Studios early next year in a whole new show attraction called Lightning McQueen's Racing Academy. Lightning McQueen, he'll be bringing the world of cars to our guests. He'll also be assisted by our friends Mater and Cruz Ramirez, and it'll be a show unlike anything that we've got anywhere else. It's just going to be so exciting.
Oh my goodness, that sounds intriguing. Any hints of what happens on this experience?
Well, you know, McQueen has learned a lot over the years, and some of his experiences he brings to us. Things don't go quite as well as we expect. We're rookie racers, and it's just going to be one of those upfront, up close and personal experiences with him that'll be here next year.
Well, cut you out indeed. And well, what other stories around Disney's Hollywood Studios will guests get to be a part of?
Also, I mean, you know those wildly popular and hilarious Mickey Mouse cartoon shorts on the Disney Channel?
I do, I love those.
How would you like to be in, I mean literally in, one of those cartoons with Mickey and Minnie?
Well, sure. Is that what guests can expect on Mickey and Minnie's Runaway Railway?
Well, considering we're following the rules, or should I say, the total lack of rules that come with cartoon logic, let's just say our guests can expect the unexpected.
Oh my Disney, that is exciting. What exactly will that be like?
Well, it will have the look, the feel, the sound, the comedy, the cadence of our Mickey shorts, cartoons, and the guests will be placed right in the middle. This attraction, Mickey and Minnie's Runaway Railway, is completely original. It will have a new song, a theme song. It will have a brand new story. And of course, Mickey, Minnie, Goofy, and all their friends will be along for the ride, but the story is really about you.
Me? Oh my goodness, well that is a little exciting. Can we hear a little more about the story?
Well, you know, if ever there was a fish out of water story, this is it, because it's all about humans when they suddenly find themselves in a crazy cartoon world where anything can happen, and anything does. So it all begins when you hop on board a cartoon train and take a really exciting, very unpredictable, and I highlight the word unpredictable, adventure with Mickey and Minnie and their best friends, and guests go into this world unlike, I guarantee you, unlike anything you've ever seen and experienced before. And let me say this, with Goofy as your train engineer, what could possibly go wrong?
Goofy's riding the train? I can only imagine what's going to happen. But the real question is, how are you going to make us feel like we're in an animated world?
Well, Sonia, Disney is known for taking theatrical techniques and technologies, integrating them in fresh and new ways, and bringing experiences to our guests.
Absolutely.
And this attraction will be no exception. At all. We are going to break the law of physics. We are going to defy logics, and we are going to put you in that animated world. And it will be an unbelievable fun experience for the entire family. And as you see on the screen here, I bet most of you think that you are looking at a piece of 2D art. But what you are looking at is actually a physical model that's about 2 feet.
About this
and
model,
it's
about
painted.
That model.
In that cartoon style. So we are pulling out all the stops in terms of putting you in that animated world.
Oh my goodness, well it sounds like it's gonna be a wacky ride. I cannot wait to experience Mickey and Minnie's Runaway Railway soon. Well now, we can't talk about the future of Disney's Hollywood Studios without mentioning one of the most highly anticipated new lands, Star Wars Galaxy's Edge. Now Scott, what can you tell us today?
Well, I guess we'll get to explore this remote outpost, catch up with some familiar characters, and meet some new ones. They'll have the chance to actually step into this amazing galaxy filled with adventures. They can expect to encounter the Resistance in the First Order, as well as discover their own Star Wars story.
Wow. Well, what exactly do you mean by discover our own Star Wars stories?
Well, this entire world is being designed so that every detail will help visitors suspend disbelief, completely immersive. The sights, sounds, and smells all come together to set the stage, the jumping-off point for their own Star Wars adventure.
Oh, so what can you tell us about this outpost you had mentioned earlier?
Pretty interesting place. The Black Spire Outpost on the never-before-seen planet of Batuu is a remote trading place on the edge of wild space. It draws those who prefer less attention. It's become a thriving port for smugglers, rogue traders, and adventurers, the kind of people Kevin and I hang out with closely. It's also a convenient safe haven for those intent on avoiding the expanding reach of the First Order. And while we may be discovering Batuu for the first time, it is well known to many of the Star Wars characters.
Oh my goodness, well that sounds like adventures waiting around every corner. Now what can you tell us about the new attractions in the land?
A little bit. We'll open with two signature attractions. One is an epic Star Wars adventure that puts you in a climactic battle, right in the middle of a climactic battle between the First Order and the Resistance. It has been described as the most epic attraction Disney has ever designed, and I think that's true. The second attraction invites guests to step aboard the Millennium Falcon and to pilot the fastest ship in the galaxy on an ever-changing interactive adventure. Your actions have consequences, and they follow you back into the outpost.
Oh, guests can help fly the Millennium Falcon, that's awesome. I'm just so excited.
It's super exciting. We're really excited for everything we have planned for Star Wars Galaxy's Edge. It's one of our most ambitious projects here at Florida Hollywood Studios, and also at Disneyland. Each one covers over 14 acres, and it's our largest single theme land expansion in our history. Super excited.
Wow, that really is a huge expansion. Well, I will not keep you here any longer because it sounds like you all have a lot. Oh, yes. Let's hear it for Kathy Mangum, Charita Carter, Kevin Rafferty, and Scott. Our last guest, let's check in one more time with our roving reporter.
Hello, I'm Mark Daniel, broadcasting live from the most magical place on earth, the Magic Kingdom. And I'm joined by Dan Soto, one of the leaders behind the Play Disney Parks mobile app, a brand new digital entertainment experience that enables guests to play big here at Walt Disney World and the Disneyland Resort in California. And, oh, that's right, it has a big debut this weekend. So tell us, what is the Play Disney Parks app?
Well, Play Disney Parks is a major step in transforming our guest experience. When you first get into the app, you have the ability to see these incredible game boards that unlock your ability to play games while you're waiting in line. You can try your hand at Disney trivia. You can even check out your favorite Disney tunes with Apple Music. It's interactive, it's immersive, and it's just fun.
Now, Dan, how is this going to change the way guests explore the parks?
Well, what's cool is the app is designed to interact with the physical environment around you. It reacts, it responds differently based on where you are in the park. Now, this isn't about walking around the park all day staring at your smartphone. It's really about engaging with your family and friends and really playing together and immersing yourself more deeply in your favorite Disney stories.
Wow, that sounds fun. I can't wait to play.
Well, you better get to it.
All right, well, let's do it.